Hi guys, I want to share with you this amazing experience from the last baptism, where we could see how God is acting today by spending freedom, deliverance and salvation. But unfortunately, when we went to the baptism, the camera fell into the water and we didn't have a substitute camera. So we don't have a record of the actual baptism. But I have material from the prayers and the confessions, which we did before the baptism, and from the testimonies afterwards. And these testimonies are very impressive. You should see them. I don't want to withhold from you, even if you cannot see the actual baptism. And I want to mention that this baptism was highly contested. We faced a lot of resistance at this day, and even the days before, as the baptism was scheduled 3 times before already, but always needed to be cancelled and postponed because of different reasons. And besides the camera that fell into the water, there was a train that had a breakdown and couldn't move on, which again postponed it for an hour or so. And while the weather was very fine all the days before, exactly at this day there was a heavy storm, which almost blew the camera from the stand. But finally we made it. You should watch these impressive testimonies by Christoph and Hannah of how their lives were transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit and how they were delivered from addictions and fear. Hannah reported about a supernatural experience with the Holy Spirit, revealing her life to her from God's perspective. This is amazing, and therefore I hope that these testimonies will be an inspiration to you and an encouragement for seeking God and getting baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So, okay, so, ihr seid bereit.
Ja. Ja.
Ihr seid bereit. Ihr wisst auch, dass Gott existiert,
ja,
dass Jesus existiert. Er hat gewirkt vor 2000 Jahren und er hat sein Leben gegeben, um für unsere Sünden zu bezahlen, mhm, ja, damit wir vom Tod errettet werden. Und das ist aus Liebe geschehen, aus Liebe zu seinen Geschöpfen, die Liebe Gottes. Denn wir stehen ja sozusagen auf seiner Erde, die er geschaffen hat, die er für uns hergerichtet hat. Vollkommen perfekt, bis in jedes kleine Atom. Ja, wir haben Luft zum Atmen, die perfekt ist. Ja, wir haben Wasser, Flüsse, Seen, wo wir frisches Wasser rausnehmen können. Wir haben alle Arten von Früchten, die wir essen können für unsere Nahrung. Er gibt uns unser tägliches Brot. Er hat uns erschaffen in seinem Abbild. Ja, deswegen ist ja Satan so eifersüchtig auf uns. He wants to steal and kill. Satan wants to steal and kill. Ja? Because er darf nicht mehr zurück. Satan darf nicht mehr zurück. Er wollte seinen Thron errichten, his throne, in the north of the throne of God. But he was cast out. He was put at the end. Er war ganz am Ende, ist er gesetzt worden. Und das Einzige, was er möchte, die geliebten Kinder Gottes, ihn möchte er schaden. Sie möchte er mit. Er kann nicht wieder zurück in den Himmel. Aber die Gerechtigkeit Gottes, die ist ja unumstößlich. The righteousness, the law of God is forever, is universal. So, Gott kann also nicht einfach sagen, ich begnadige euch. Ja? Und deshalb hat Gott seinem Volk Israel gesagt, ihr könnt nur von euren Sünden befreit werden, wenn ihr ein Opfer, wenn es ein Opfer gibt. Denn in der Bibel steht, der Preis der Sünde ist der Tod. The price of sin is death. So, we have to pay our price with our own death, for our own sins. I hope the camera will not disappear by the storm. But God loves the humans more than the animals. Ja, er liebt die Menschen mehr. Und deswegen hat er ihnen erlaubt, ihr dürft die Tiere opfern, damit ihr gerettet werdet vom Tod. Aber Jesus hat gesagt, die Opfer der Tiere ist vorbei. Denn was geschieht, wenn ich eine Sünde begehe? Ich muss ständig Opfer bringen. Und Jesus hat gesagt, ich bin euer Opfer, ein für alle Mal, one and forever. one sacrifice, me, and I give my life. Und Gott hat die Menschen so geliebt, ja, dass er ihnen erstmal alles hier, er hat uns alles gegeben. Er hat alles nur für uns hier aufgestellt. Ja. Aber die Menschen haben ihn nicht gewollt. They have put God aside. The humans have put God aside. They thought they don't need God. And God did not push us away. Er hat uns nicht verworfen, sondern er hat uns noch seinen einzigen geliebten Sohn gegeben. His only beloved son. He sent us his only beloved son. And he looked at him. And he looked at his sacrifice. The crucifixion needed 9 hours. So we can imagine what he has suffered for us. Ja, was er für uns durchgemacht hat. 9 hours. The sacrifice, it was brutal. So much has God loved the people that he gave his only beloved son. That everybody who believes in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life. Und wenn wir das wissen, das wisst ihr, you know it, wollen wir heute unser Leben Jesus geben. Jesus übergeben und ihn als unseren Herrn und Erlöser annehmen. Let's pray. Vater im Himmel, wir beten zu dir im Namen Jesu. Vater, wir kommen heute hier zusammen, um unseren Bruder Christoph und unsere Schwester Hannah im Namen Jesu zu taufen und sie in die volle Gotteskindschaft und Nachfolge Jesu hineinzubringen. Vater, wir geben alles in deine Hände. Wir vertrauen vollkommen auf deinen Heiligen Geist, dass er uns führt und schützt. So bitten wir dich, Vater, sende uns den Heiligen Geist. Erfülle uns mit dem Heiligen Geist. Und wir bitten dich, Herr Jesus, sei in unserer Mitte und gib uns deinen Segen. Give us your blessing and anointing. Denn dein Wort sagt, wenn zwei oder mehr zusammenkommen und beten, dann bin ich in ihrer Mitte. Denn wir wissen, die Taufe im Glauben, nicht die Babytaufe, denn sie entspricht nicht deinem Wort, Herr. Aber die Taufe im Glauben ist unerlässlich, um als Kind Gottes neugeboren und angenommen zu werden. Denn dein Wort sagt, wer nicht neugeboren ist aus Wasser und Geist, kann das Reich Gottes nicht sehen. Herr Jesus, so gehen wir in Gehorsam. Denn wie das Wasser den Leib reinigt in der Taufe, so hat bei deinen Kindern Christoph und Hannah die Reinigung ihres Lebens von ihrer Sündenschuld stattgefunden. Und dies bezeugen sie und bekennen sie und zeigen sie durch ihren Taufgehorsam. Herr Jesus, du bist gestorben am Kreuz für unsere Sünden, um uns vom Tod zu erlösen und uns das ewige Leben zu geben. So bitten wir heute, errette auch unseren Bruder Christoph und unsere Schwester Hannah und führe sie in die volle Gotteskindschaft und in die volle Jüngerschaft zu deinen Ehren. Praise the Lord. Halleluja. Amen. Glaubst du, dass Jesus Christus, der Sohn Gottes ist, der in unsere Welt gekommen ist, um seinen Leib hinzugeben zur Vergebung unserer Sünden?
Absolut.
Ja. Absolut. Ja. Bekennst du deine Sünden? Tust du Buße über sie? Und entsagst du allen Sünden?
Ja.
Bist du bereit, dein Leben Jesus zu übergeben und ihn als deinen Herrn und Erlöser anzunehmen? Your Lord and Savior.
Ja.
Ja. Um durch sein unschuldiges, vergossenes Blut reingewaschen zu werden von deinen Sünden und erlöst zu werden vom Tod.
Ja.
Ja. Und um das ewige Leben und die volle Gotteskindschaft von Gott, dem Vater im Himmel, zu erhalten. Ja. Halleluja, Halleluja. Halleluja. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
So, wie war die Taufe für euch? Christoph, vielleicht kannst du mal
ich glaube, sagen. Ja, das war schon sehr erhaben, also zu sehen, was man für eine Last auf sich trägt, zu fühlen und wie man die Last abgeben kann auf diese verschiedenen Dämonen, die man in sich trägt und nicht zugeben will, dass man sie hat und dass man
Du hast auch gesagt, du hast was gefühlt, dass irgendwas durch deinen Körper gegangen ist oder dass was rausgegangen ist?
Ja, durchaus. Es ist wirklich gefühlbar gewesen, dass was weicht.
Was hast du genau? Kannst du das irgendwie beschreiben? Aber du hast auch richtig was körperlich
gefühlt. Ich habe auch was körperlich gefühlt.
Also wenn was aus dir raus
kommt. Ja, durchaus, ja.
Also Kribbeln
gehabt? Kribbeln und ein Gefühl von unglaubliches Gefühl, dass...
Erleichterung?
Erleichterung, ja.
Wirklich?
Genau, ja.
Ich hatte auch das Gefühl, dass was rausgegangen ist. Du hast auch gestrahlt dann.
Ja. Ja, unglaubliche Erleichterung. Ja. Ja. Der ganzen Prozess war das so. Jetzt. Ja, das war so.
Hast du den Eindruck gehabt, dass du befreit wirst?
Ja, also ich hatte das schon, dass ich schon auch viel besetzt bin und war, ohne das zuzugeben. Und dann habe ich gemerkt, dass schon eine Befreiung da ist, auch dass ich auch einfach ja viel per se auch viel glücklicher bin. Also.
Ja, hast du gemerkt?
Ja.
Freier, glücklicher, fühlt sich freier?
Ja, ja.
Das ist tatsächlich ein Zeichen dafür, dass dich was verlassen hat. Ja? Dass du freier geworden bist. Ja. Halleluja. Preis den Herrn. In English, English. So, you have experienced the baptism, but you have received the Holy Ghost earlier already, and you have given your life to Christ.
Receiving the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Then I can say I felt something completely physical. It was like a puppet, and I was the hand in the puppet, and then I removed my hand, and almost something, a new hand came in, you know?
Yeah.
And it was that powerful when I first felt it. Yeah, I felt like it was a mental release, you know, because I was telling Christoph that I have kind of been struggling of completely letting go of this old body, you know, this old the attachments that I had to the guilt that I used to have. So it was kind of like I know that I'm new in Christ, but still, like, I still get attacked sometimes, as in I feel like, no, you're still this.
You said you gave your life to Christ
mm-hmm.
last year, right. So a year ago.
It's awesome. Definitely been a growing process, I would say, that I'm getting to know myself again, because I had to completely let go of who I thought I was, you know, and I had to start over, as if I didn't know who I was, because I had to let go of everything that I thought I was, all of these sins and stuff, and so now I am left with, who am I, you know? I'm so scared of letting this go, because that's all I know, and if I let this go, then who am I going to be, you know? So it's been this journey from starting at the beginning of God telling me who I am and God telling me who He is. Yeah, because you look at the world in a completely different perspective. And so this new perspective sheds light on the darkness that I was living in, you know? And in the darkness you can't see the truth and can't see what you really want, you know? Because I did want it all along. Everyone wants it. Our souls all cry out for this love that Jesus offers, you know? And once I received that love, it was like, I have it, I'm good.
Yeah.
I don't need
you
this
felt
other, I don't need these drugs, or I don't need this other stimulation to make me feel alive, because I felt alive.
You talked about it previously. You struggled with drugs before you gave your life to Jesus,
definitely.
Right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
And Jesus healed you from this.
Oh, completely. It was a night and day experience.
Yeah.
After, because it was all submission in one point, you know? Like, I completely gave myself away.
And how did you come to this decision?
It was
remember?
It was, yes, I will never forget it.
Okay.
It was this supernatural experience,
right.
Actually.
Okay.
Yeah,
really?
So I was at a festival alone. And I was walking, and I was actually doing drugs at that festival previously to this, and I was walking, and I felt this presence with me, like it was like this mirror came up, it convicted me.
Yeah.
I felt convicted, and I felt like it was all of a sudden I was able to look at myself and be like, and confront myself with how I'd been living, you know?
Yeah,
it was this moment of conviction, and all of my surroundings became one, and it was like spinning, and I felt like this almost tormented, almost, and
You in this moment.
Yes, completely. And so
So the demons pulled on you.
Yes,
they want to pull you back into the life that you live.
Yeah, and this
into the world.
Yes, and I went like this, and I was praying to God. It was like, I don't care about anything other than you right now. I'm sorry. You know, this was a point of, I am sorry. This is,
you repented of your sin.
You know, and I know, and it was this moment. I can't, almost indescribable moment. And I prayed that, you know, I'm done. I am done with living this way. You know, I'm thirsty for something, and the water that I'm drinking isn't quenching my thirst. I need you. I need something more than this. And then I lifted my head, and all my strength.
But he showed you your life, right? You said you saw your life like in a mirror, right?
Yeah. I saw myself confronted. You know, it was like I finally confronted myself with how I'd been living, because this whole time I've just been making excuses for myself in this way, or making my excuses in this way, or not really being true to myself.
Right, not so conscious.
Yes, it was a breakthrough that I had, and it was totally by God's grace that this had happened to me. And
that He showed you your life, how you live, and how it is from His perspective, actually.
Exactly, right? Exactly. Right. That's exactly what it was. And I felt so safe with Him, and I was able to be honest with myself in this moment. And, not let my pride get in the way, or, you know, completely just humble myself, you know?
Yeah. And you did this then?
Yeah.
And this was last year?
Yeah, this was last March, so yeah, a little over a year ago. It was a moment that I'll never...
And then you gave your life to Jesus, and incidentally, you don't have anything, any addiction with drugs or something.
No.
It's a way, right?
Yeah. It's just so...
you are delivered.
Why would I want this anymore?
You don't want
it
this.
Was,
it has changed you.
Yeah, completely.
And today it's the baptism.
Yeah,
so something spiritual.
It was this more of a mental breakthrough for me, because it was... Sometimes I was struggling with just completely believing that I am this new person, right? Because I feel like this new person, but do I really believe it all the time? Because I'm not perfect. I'm definitely not perfect.
We are still not perfect.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
But we have now the grace.
Right.
So we can go to Jesus again and say and repent.
Mm-hmm.
He wants us to repent every day.
Mm-hmm.
So but we are not sinning willfully.
Right.
So because we are free from this, it's gone,
mm-hmm.
and you have experienced this in the baptism, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You feel light.
Yeah. But it was really nice to see this.
Hallelujah, praise God.
Guys, I'm glad that I could share this amazing experience with you, and I hope that it will edify and inspire you seeking a personal relationship with God, since this is what He wants us to do. He doesn't want us to sit in the church and repeat stand-up prayers, but to pray to Him personally. Humble yourself in front of the Holy Father, repent of your sins, turn away from your carnal desires, and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. To walk with Jesus is an exciting journey, and it is the only salvation. There is no one time saved, forever saved. He wants us to seek Him all time of our life, not only sometimes when we have a hard time, as we are not supposed to be part-time Christians. Seek Him, and you shall find Him. Ask, and it shall be given to you. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. God bless you.